各位好，欢迎收看今天的凤凰大视野。监狱是囚禁犯罪者的地方，在这里罪犯的人身自由和权益受到了高度的限制。不过为了让犯罪者不再重蹈覆辙，有些监狱开始了创意的改造计划。本周我们的节目将会聚焦世界各地的监狱，一一进行实地探访，去见证那些创意改造计划是如何改变囚犯的。在菲律宾的巴拉望省有一座舞蹈监狱，在关押期间，为了改造囚犯，让他们减少暴力，这座监狱推陈出新，通过舞蹈来改造犯人。
为了舒缓囚犯们因生活在过度拥挤的空间以及等待无限期受审的精神压力，巴拉望省监狱自2013年开始把舞蹈加入改造计划的同时，也曾经尝试举办篮球赛、拳击赛等活动让囚犯参与。不过最终还是觉得舞蹈计划较有成效。
那你觉得这个监狱舞蹈大赛呢，对里面的受刑人有什么样的帮助呢？
Pagsasayaw ng mga dancing inmate ay nakakabigay aliw at nakakaaliw din sa kanila at nakakatulong din sa kanilang kalusugan dahil nakakapag-exercise po.
其实把舞蹈当作改造计划并不是巴拉望省监狱首创。宿务省级拘留中心是监狱舞蹈的创始者，该拘留中心因为开创了监狱舞蹈的改造计划而备受瞩目，甚至有囚犯出狱后当起舞蹈老师。看见成功改造的例子，巴拉望省监狱也开始效仿，推出了自己的舞蹈改造计划。虽然最后宿务省级拘留中心的舞蹈改造计划因为一些原因在2016年暂停，不过巴拉望省监狱却让舞蹈改造计划在监狱延续。在1200多名囚犯当中，巴拉望省监狱目前有10%的囚犯参与这项舞蹈改造计划。监狱当局希望有更多囚犯会参加计划，进而减少身上的戾气。
啊，刚刚跳得很好，我想问一下，为什么你会想要参加监狱舞蹈？
Para malibangan sarili, hindi mag-isip ng kung anong bagay na ano, hindi maganda. Tapos para rin sa kalusugan, kalusugan din namin na mga bilanggo. Malaki na itutulong sa aming mga bilanggo na sumayo ng mga ganito, magsali sa mga activities ng ganito, para makita rin ng ibang tao na hindi porke bilanggo kami, bilanggo na lang kami. Meron din kaming mga ugali na pwedeng makahilubilo sa ibang tao na talagang naharapan din kami na ano, sumali sa mga mamayan na sa labas. Hindi, porque bilanggo ang tingin sa amin, bilanggo na lang.
Roel 原本就是名舞者，被关押之前，他是在当地电视节目中表演舞蹈。拥有舞蹈背景的他，现在是 B 座舞蹈团队的小队长。
Natural lang mahirap, may pagod, pero kasama naman yun talaga sa ginagawa namin eh. Pero enjoy din naman, masaya naman kami sa ginagawa namin.
Roel 的家乡科隆距离巴拉望省监狱400公里。4年前因为犯罪而被关押在巴拉望省监狱，他就与妻小分离。由于距离遥远，交通费昂贵，这些年，妻子只在 Roel 刚入狱的第7个月探望过他。
Hindi lang naman magkadalaw sa akin dito pag yung mga kasama ko may dinadalaw, tapos napansin na ako sa loob, panakita ako, nakakilala ko, sinasama na lang ako sa dinadalaw nila. Pero talaga hindi naman sa akin dalaw, yung kumbaga kakilala lang na isinama lang ako sa dalaw nila. Dahil ng emotion mo, iisip ka ba't mo nagawa yung mga pagkakamali or pwede mo namang iwasan. Masalo na pag kumawa sa isip mo yung mga pamilya mo, mga naiiwan mo sa ang mahal mo sa buhay sa labas. Yung talagang nung nag-iisa talagang nagpapabigat sa amin eh, yung mga mahal mo sa buhay na naiiwan mo. Hindi naman talaga maiwasan yung pagtulo ng luha mo eh. Para maiwasan lang yung pag-iisip ng mga kung ano-ano, sumasali na lang kami sa mga activities na inaano ng mga ng pamunuan. Mga tulad ng mga basketball, volleyball, yan. Sayaw, saka may mga ibang gawain, pagsamba.
Udao Gaizao Jihua, doi jianyu dangju eryan, shi yizhong gaizao qiufan de gongju ziyi. 但对无限期等待受审的囚犯来说，是种重要的心灵寄托。根据2017年的资料显示，世界上犯罪率最高的110个国家中，菲律宾排名第62，主要的罪行包括卖淫。 贩卖人口和毒品走私。由于菲律宾的司法体制关系，审判过程一般非常缓慢。那些正在等待受审的囚犯就会被暂时关押在监狱内。巴拉望省监狱共有2座监狱大楼 ，A 座收押的全是男性囚犯，而 B 座监禁的囚犯也是男性为主。不过，由于巴拉望省没有女性监狱。 所以，巴拉望省监狱现在也收押63名女性囚犯，他们目前被关押在 B 座的特别牢房里。Mr. Rabago 在巴拉望省监狱担任副典狱长已有15年，他告诉我们，巴拉望省监狱里的囚犯因各种罪名，包括谋杀、强暴、抢劫，还有走私贩毒等罪名而被判入狱。 巴拉望省监狱囚禁的囚犯年龄层从18岁到70多岁，其中以18岁至30岁这个年龄层为最多。由于菲律宾的司法体制关系，审判过程非常缓慢，这些囚犯就先被收押在监狱，有些等了几年，有些却等了10多年才被审判。无论是有罪还是无罪。 在法官下判之前，这些人能做的就只有等待。据说有些囚犯在监狱里等了足足17年，现在已经将近70岁了。其实有些囚犯因为罪行种类是能被允许保释在外，但有些则因为无法缴付保释金而被继续关押在巴拉望省监狱。 由于大多的囚犯都在等待着无限期的审判，因此监狱当局就推出各种不同活动，让囚犯们有身心上的寄托。We
have a lot of sports here, basketball, volleyball, okay, dama, chess. We have ALS alternative learning center for them to read, to write, so that when they release. From provincial jail back to society, they can have a job and well educated, well what we call responsible society again.
其实，巴拉望省监狱最受瞩目的一项特色就是监狱推出的囚犯跳舞活动。 自2013年开始，巴拉望省监狱就开始把舞蹈列入改造计划之一，每个星期都有舞蹈老师前来教授。据说，如果舞蹈老师有事无法前来，则会由有经验的囚犯带领大家练习。Yung
pagtuturo namin kasi hindi sila mga dancer. Isa-isahin pa namin sila pagturo ng maayos kasi. Hindi nila nakamulatang magsayaw. Iba-iba kasing pagkatao nila.
通常你都教他们跳什么样的舞蹈啊?
Modern dance, folk dance, creative dance. Mas marami sa Pilipino. Kasi kailangan na maano nila yung kultura namin.
Jianyu 也提供囚犯学习理发和制作手工等技能。 行为良好的囚犯，只要他们有兴趣，监狱当局会拨出土地让囚犯们种菜。
This is our garden area. Welcome. The lettuce plant.
生菜, are they going to sell or
yes,
eat themselves?
Yes, sell. The market.
Oh, 这些都是 这些菜园种的菜都是拿去市场卖哦，
really?
不是自己要吃的。 Chili.
Yeah.
啊
Chili. Eggplant.
啊，那茄子啦，还有刚刚有看到辣椒，小辣椒。
Morning.
Good morning.
One of the our inmate assigned here. This is our vegetable garden.
Wow, very big, but only a few people here.
29 all in all.
29个人负责在这边种菜了.
They can send money for the children.
Oh.
Only from planting vegetable. This is also one of the privileges of our inmates.
都可以拿去卖到市场，然后听说可以养家活口，把钱寄出去给他们的家人。整个菜园满满的茄子、白菜等各种当地常见的蔬菜，都是囚犯每日用心耕耘的成果。这些蔬菜的顾客群主要是囚犯的访客家属。 巴拉旺省监狱的菜园每年的收成所得会平均分给囚犯们，让他们即使与家人分离，也能为家人尽些责任。Yes,
grotto.
哇，原来这个是那个受刑人自己做出来的，很有心。看来在这边信仰还是很重要的，而且这些材料都是好像是从那个菜园那边弄过来。 自己做的 ，How many days did they make? It take to make this.
A couple of weeks.
做了几个礼拜。巴拉旺省监狱改变了一般人对监狱的印象。这个监狱其实更像是一个东南亚里的小村落。由于都是还没被审判的囚犯，监狱当局对他们的管制比较不严格，囚犯们能在规定范围内自由活动。
我身后呢，就是女受刑人的牢房了，总共有2间，然后据说里面住了5、60个女受刑人，然后这边呢会跟那个男受刑人的牢房有做一个隔离这样子。这些女性囚犯一旦被判刑，她们将会被转移到马尼拉的女子监狱。根据国际标准，每间牢房中理想的关押人数是16名囚犯。 不过，巴拉旺省监狱里的囚犯每天凌晨5点起床，6点钟监狱当局会开始点算人头。我刚刚以为啊是全部一起点人头，原来是一间一间牢房这样子算的。
早上9点至下午5点是囚犯们能在监狱范围内自由活动的时间。巴拉旺省监狱和别的监狱不同的另一点是，每天早上9点至下午5点这段期间，囚犯家属们经过登记，监狱当局就会允许家属近距离探访囚犯，而且没有限定每次逗留的时间。家属甚至可以自行准备食物带给囚犯吃。 此外，访客中心还有卡拉 OK 系统，让囚犯与家属有娱乐活动。巴拉旺省监狱副典狱长告诉我们，监狱当局希望囚犯们在亲人家属的关爱下，能够摆脱昔日的陋习，不再踏上犯罪的旧路。 而这次监狱当局特别批准摄制队进入监狱里的中央厨房拍摄。
现在是一个难得的机会，可以拍他们的中央厨房哦。让我们来看看他们到底午餐啊，还有晚餐到底吃些什么，还要看看一下厨房的状况。Hello， 哇，现在在切那个南瓜，一个人负责切，这个设备都比较简陋一点点。然后这里在干什么呢？他们的那个炉子很特别哦。哦，在煮饭啊，而且好多桶的饭。天啊，听说他们一天啊要煮11袋的米来供所有的送行人吃饭。
相对于巴拉望省监狱里日复一日的生活作息，围墙外的世界正值热闹的6月份。每年6月份，巴拉望省政府都会举办为期2个星期的系列活动，庆祝巴拉望省成立日。这是当地最盛大的文化庆典，会有花车游行和舞蹈表演等活动。而今年巴拉望省监狱的舞蹈比赛也是当地政府的庆典活动之一。
Baragatan is a yearly celebration of the provincial government of Palawan. This is the second time I joined the Baragatan, but this time composed of 2 groups.From main building and annex building, they contest each other and they have a prize coming from our governor, 25,000.
一直以来，巴拉望省监狱当局都努力争取让囚犯们有公开表演的机会，希望让他们在关押期间也能融入社会。2015年，在舞蹈改造计划下的囚犯首次参与庆祝活动。他们呈现团队舞蹈来庆祝巴拉望省成立日。为了这次的舞蹈比赛，政府还派编舞老师分别教导 A 座和 B 座的囚犯如何挑选舞蹈、制作道具，还有舞蹈的各种情感呈现等技巧。对参赛的囚犯来说，最挑战的是他们必须得在3个星期内学会各自选择的民族舞、部落舞和现代舞等4支舞蹈。
Kasi nakarang taon, puro modern lang. Ngayon may kasamang cultural, creative, pinaghalo-halo nila para mapahaba pa yung sayo.
这些囚犯们多数没有舞蹈背景，要熟记那么多的舞步和站位，非常考验他们的耐心。要组成一队一同比赛，更是考验彼此间的默契。
The difference while teaching outside those dancers is very different from teaching here inside the jail, because when teaching outside the dancers, those dancers, it's very easy. It's like just give them accountings, easy choreographies, they will get it easily. But here, you need to teach them one by one, count by count, and sometimes they were very hard-headed, but you need patience, a lot of patience. I think this event will help a lot for the inmates to, you know, to run away from boredom. Also, this serves as a bonding for all the inmates.
来自 A 座的 Michelle 是其中一名准备参加比赛的囚犯，他已经在巴拉望省监狱2年半了。原本没有舞蹈背景的 Michelle 觉得参加监狱舞蹈训练让沉闷的牢狱生活有了新希望。
Bilang isang dancer dito sa panlalawigang piitan po, gusto po namin mangyari po na bilang kaming detinado dito sa loob ng panlalawigang piitan, gusto namin mangyari na maging masaya, iwas boryong. Sapagkat nagkakaroon kami ng organized na itong sayaw na ito para sa lahat ng mga detinado upang maging masaya kami dito sa loob ng bilangguan po. Bilang isang inmates dito sa loob ng panlalawigang piitan, hindi naman lubos namin maiisip na nandyan po ang paghihirap dito sa loob ng kulungan. maging masaya din kami kasi nandiyan naman po appreciable dito sa mga lahat ng binigay ng lahat ng mga biyaya na binibigay ng aming gobernador na Jose Chavez Alvarez.
目前, Michelle 和队友努力地排练, 并期待在接下来的比赛中能脱颖而出, 成为冠军。 监狱囚犯们为了比赛付出汗水和努力，他们每天利用自由活动的时间训练5个小时。囚犯们甚至缝制自己的出场服装，他们特别看重比赛，不仅是因为优胜队伍可以获得奖金，更重要的是为自己、队友和家人赢得荣耀。 经过了3个星期的排练后，巴拉旺省监狱内的囚犯们终于迎来了他们翘首企盼的舞蹈比赛。哇
，B 队已经开始在彩排了。为了等一下那个舞蹈比赛，看得出比前几天更加的认真，更加的专注。
今天下午2点就是正式的比赛，A 座和 B 座的囚犯们一早就开始努力排练，为比赛做最后冲刺。Hindi
naman kami nag-iisip talaga ng panalo. Iniisip lang namin yung makasahil na kami sa activities ng ganyan para malibang yung sarili namin. Hindi kami nakahangad ng panalo sa prize. Kung magkano ang price. Basta sa amin, sumayal lang kami, masaya na kami.
Jianyu舞蹈大赛 马上就要开始了，在我的右手边呢，就是这一次比赛的评审，还有旁边呢，都是他们的家人朋友到场来支持他们，甚至还有地方的电视台来这边采访。 当然少不了今天的主角，也是 A 队还有 B
队。今天呢，都非常的振奋，非常的开心。等一下呢，就看到底哪一队可以拿到冠军吧。今天的舞蹈比赛是巴拉旺省成立日系列庆祝活动之一，也是巴拉旺省监狱首次举办舞蹈比赛，因此当地电视台也特地派队来巴拉旺省监狱采访。 现场不仅可看到其他囚犯围绕在一旁等着看比赛，也可看见有囚犯家属到场观赛支持。Una
isang napakalaking pasasalamat po sa ngalan ng aming mga residente. Yung aming mga detainees dito hindi namin tinatawag na detenido kundi mga residente. Yung mga selda nila, ang tawag natin sa selda nila, dorm. Kasi inaalis po namin sa kanilang kaisipan na sila ay mga bilanggo. Isang napakalaking pagkakataon na makasama kami sa pagdiriwang ng Barangatan.
Di ko kabisado yung siyensiya. Ako'y nalilito sa maraming salita.
舞蹈比赛以类别区分，A 座和 B 座的囚犯轮流上场。率先登场的是来自 A 座的囚犯，他们带着精心制作的道具，透过舞蹈展示菲律宾人的传统生活，生动地呈现当地人捕鱼和种稻的情况。 之后轮到 B 座囚犯上场，他们也不遑多让，惟妙惟肖地展示猎人打猎的情况。传统文化舞蹈之后就是民族舞，这也是摄制队在拍摄期间经常看见 A 座和 B 座囚犯一直在排练的舞蹈。舞蹈可以是一项运动爱好，也可以说是打发时间的方法之一，但对这群不自由的人而言，或许有更深层的意义。或许曾经一时迷糊犯了错，但这不代表接下来的人生他们会一直沉沦。
Kung sa hirap talagang mahirap din kami dinadanasan, pero kasama talaga sa ginagawa namin eh. Pero masaya naman kami sa ginagawa namin kasi nalilibang kami sa mga ano, sa mga ginagawa namin, tapos nakikita kami ng ibang tao na dumadalaw dito na hindi lang kami bilanggo, talagang may activities din kami sinasalihan katulad ng mga sayaw, ganito, saka may mga marami pa rin pwedeng gawin.
Ang may bibigay naming tulong bilang sa mga dancers po, sa lahat ng mga detinado dito, maging masaya lang lahat upang kami ay iwas boryong na naman, dahil nga kami ay nakakulong dito sa panalawigang piitan, kami ay may hinaharap ng mga kaso.
即使连续跳了好几支舞蹈，从这些囚犯脸上看见的不是疲惫，而是希望，因为这是难得能让外界看见他们努力用心的时刻。
好，现在是评审们的伤脑筋的时间了。我刚刚看了比赛啊， A 队跟 B 队真的是旗鼓相当，我真的是不知道谁会是今天的冠军。看完之后，其实我本来觉得是 A 队，但是我觉得 B 队也有可能，所以我们再等一下下就知道谁会是冠军啦。
为了表扬囚犯这段期间用心筹备和排练，巴拉望省监狱当局除了选出冠军队伍之外，也设立了另外两个奖项，最有纪律奖和最佳服饰奖。
冠军出炉。
最终 B 座的囚犯是这次比赛的大赢家，获得最佳服饰奖和冠军。兴奋的他们随性地跳多一支舞蹈，还拉黄靖伦一起分享他们的喜悦。
Ngayon, mahirap pa rin magsabi talaga ang takbo ng gulong ng buhay kung saan talaga pupunta eh. Pero hindi pa rin kami nawala ng pag-asa na makalaya.
为了减缓牢房过度拥挤以及囚犯们无限期等待受审的精神压力，菲律宾的巴拉望省监狱把舞蹈纳入改造计划当中，从原本纯粹是监狱内的立场活动，渐渐地受到当地政府的关注，并成为当地庆典系列活动之一。对这些囚犯而言，或许外界的认可是一种鼓励。囚犯因为犯了罪而必须接受法律制裁，在监狱内服刑。如果犯人能够成功地接受改造，有朝一日在铁窗外，他们或许还可以找到人生新的起点。 各位好，欢迎收看今天的凤凰大视野。当监狱的囚犯遇上流浪犬，一场互相的救赎就此展开。在全球最危险的监狱美国的富尔顿监狱里，有一项温情的改造计划，犬只救援与训练计划，目的是通过说明拯救被遗弃的狗儿，让接受训狗技能的囚犯学会一技之长，增强纪律，并减少再犯罪的可能性。
根据美国司法统计局的资料显示，美国的囚犯人数是世界上最高的，单单2013年就有230万人被判入狱，也就是说，每110个人当中就有一位正在监狱服刑。虽然这数目只占全球人口4%，但是全世界几乎每4位在监狱服刑的人当中就有一位在美国。更严重的是，美国的再犯率也非常高。司法统计局的资料显示，被释放的美国囚犯有高达76%的囚犯在5年内再次犯罪。许多监狱因此绞尽脑汁展开各类改造计划，希望能扭转这个趋势。其中一个就是富尔顿的犬只救援与训练计划。
These men come into this program with walls around them. The dogs can put a crack in that surface simply by loving these men. And once that happens, that's when we have the ability to make a difference for them.
位于美国亚特兰大佐治亚州的富尔顿监狱是一间拘留待审被告的环押监狱，它被称为美国最危险的监狱之一。任何事情都有可能发生，帮派斗争、毒品贩卖、偷窃，甚至越狱和谋杀。这间多层监狱囚禁了大约2500名囚犯，许多囚犯替监狱取了昵称，名为 Rice Street， 也就是此监狱的地址。基于保安原因，监狱当局只允许摄制队拍摄举办犬只改造计划的副楼，也是最低戒备的区域。主要的大楼，也就是所谓的 Rice Street， 完全禁止我们入内。
Okay， 这里呢就是他们训练狗的课室。现在你看到在我身后的呢就是 Dog Handler， 然后还有他们也是这里的犯人。现在那只狗狗呢已经很兴奋了。已经迫不及待要开始训练。
K9 Cellmates 犬只训练劳改计划，简称 CCM， 创办于2013年，目前已是第17期。每一期的计划长达10周，而每一期完毕后休息2周，然后再开始新的学期，一直延续到现在。
The program is 10 weeks long. The first week is orientation week for the men.And they start to learn a little bit about the basics of the techniques that they're going to use to train the dogs while they're there. So when they've been there a week, we bring the dogs over. The first week that the dogs are there is also no formal training. It's bonding week because dogs train better with handlers that they're bonded to than they do with handlers that they're not.
Sit. Down.接下来的几个星期，囚犯的目标是训练狗儿通过基本服从测试，从而增加狗儿被领养的几率。目前是第17期的第9周，这一期的训狗教练长官是 Janet。
All the dogs been working on basic obedience, sits, downs, watch me, focusing on their handler, learning to take directions from them, learn how to settle on a mat in class.Learn how to settle in their crates, in their living space. And then we progress the training beyond basic obedience, and we kind of work with each individual dog, see what kind of progress they make.
这些狗儿来自和 CCM 紧密合作的富尔顿动物协会。计划的要求颇高，教导囚犯的必须是专业训狗师。一学期8周，每周5天，每次训练长达1小时30分钟。CCM 的宗旨是只利用正面引导的方式训练犬只，包括响片训练、奖励和赞扬来鼓励狗儿。
Okay, so you see his up here in front of everybody, bring you this way, okay? Instead of having him try and spin when he's looking at all this and everything's going on out here, come here, sweetheart, come here.
My goal is to teach them through working with the dogs that you can achieve results simply by telling the dog what they do right. You don't hear any of these guys going no or eh or not no, that's not what I ask you for. We don't even use that in our vocabulary. Just the absence of the correction is enough for the dog to figure out, okay, that's not what you wanted, let me give you something else.
Nice job, everyone. I saw a lot of really good progress. I saw a lot of good focus. I mean,
正面引导的教导方式不仅是应用于狗儿，在训练过程中，囚犯也相对受到尊重，享有尊严，不会被责骂。
We push positive reinforcement in all aspects of the program. These guys have heard all their life everything that they've done wrong. They've been told where they screwed up, when they failed, why they're in. Nobody needs to come in here and tell them what they're doing wrong. It's really impactful on me because you see these guys who come in very hard around the edges and very closed off start to open up and handle these dogs with such attention and affection. And that's my primary goal as the trainer, is to share that with them and show them how to use the good and tell the dog what they're doing right and how to apply that to their own lives.
每一期监狱当局与 CCM 会选出10到12名囚犯，将他们与5到6只狗儿配对，通常一只狗儿会跟至少2名囚犯搭配。原因是这里是拘留所，有些参与 CCM 的囚犯可能会在计划进行过程中被释放、上庭或甚至被调走，导致他们无法完成整个计划。安排至少2名囚犯训练同一只狗儿，因此能更好地确保狗儿顺利完成10周的训练计划。此外，有2名囚犯共同负责照顾一只狗，也能让他们发挥团队精神。其中一名参与计划的新生是 Anthony， 目前他只参与了3个星期，当时他被选中取代另一名获释的囚犯。
Yeah, I was a little intimidated by him at first. So I was like, oh man, he's gonna bite me or something. But I mean, none of these dogs, they're like all barking, no biting. They just want attention just like we do.
虽然 Anthony 参与这项计划只有短短3个星期，但是他和狗儿 Luke 已建立了深厚的情感。今年34岁的 Anthony， 17岁以来的生活就离不开监狱。
I couldn't tell you how many times I've been in and out of jail, but I've been to prison 4 times. I've probably been in jail probably about 16 times. I really got blessed to be applied for this program and then got put in here. Otherwise, before that, it's really nothing good.
被选中参与犬只训练改造计划后，Anthony 顺利从 Rice Streets 转调到这个低戒备的开放式营房。在他以前服刑的 Rice Streets 监狱，一个狭小的牢房住着2名囚犯，非常拥挤，而暴力事件随时有可能发生。
See how quiet it is? It's never that quiet over there. You're locked down all the time over there. Depending on what floor you're on, it can get a little rough, a little violent. Over here, you can just sleep better.
脱离了拥挤又危险的生活环境后， Anthony 从原本的负面情绪调整过来，积极投入教导狗儿 Liu 的训练中。他也认识到学习了基本的训狗技能，假以时日在出狱后或许可以是他谋生的工具。
Just being with the dogs, helping them, training them, it's like they look up to me, they rely on me to help them out and do stuff, and I like that.I don't know, I guess it gave me like a sense of purpose, where before it was like, I really didn't care. But the way I'd say he changed me is like he opened my eyes up a little bit. He opened my eyes up to a better view of everything, what's around me and what goes on. I can think a little bit clearer.
1, 2, 3, here we go, good job!
这是 Anthony 第一次参与这项计划，而他坚信这项计划改变了他，并希望这是他最后一次入狱。
I call my dad, I call him, and I brag about it all the time. I mean, he's excited for my dad's 80 years old, and he's the one that's like, hey, you know, when you get out, you need to stay with it, stick with it, you know. I mean, I'm going to, but I've never had a chance to encounter nothing like this. I really do like it. I enjoy it. It's fun. It keeps me out of all the nonsense over there at the other jail, and I learn something new every day, pretty much.
K9 Cellmates 简称 CCM 是富尔顿监狱推出最成功的改造计划之一，这项计划也获得当地治安官的鼎力支持。对创办人 Susan 而言，这项计划的成功其实得来不易。富尔顿监狱当局一开始并不相信这项计划对囚犯会有多大的帮助，或者对减少再犯率是否有效。
Our society doesn't like to think of incarcerated people as human beings. As a society, we tend to throw them away, and we don't want to think about them because it's uncomfortable. So we just dismiss them. If they're wearing a jumpsuit or something like that, they must be bad people. They're probably exactly where they need to be, and they probably should stay there for the rest of their life.
毒品滥用、帮派斗争和暴力事件使富尔顿监狱挂上美国最危险监狱的耸人称号。改造囚犯似乎成了一项艰巨和近乎不可能的任务。Susan 千辛万苦才说服监狱当局和他合作，执行这项双赢的计划。
I started working on it in January of 2012, and it took 18 months of meeting with Fulton County a lot of times.Going back to the drawing board a lot of times. And it was difficult because it's something that's totally outside their realm of consciousness of anything they had ever done before. And they couldn't imagine how it could possibly work or why they would even want to try.
富尔顿监狱当局根本无法想象训练犬只将如何有助改变囚犯的本性。
Our program is more about the men than it is about the dogs.I love the dogs. I want to save the dogs. If all we wanted to do was save dogs, we would be a typical rescue organization. The dogs are the instruments of change for these men. They do something that we probably couldn't do otherwise because these men come into this program with walls around them. The dogs can put a crack in that surface simply by loving these men andWhen the men see that these dogs love them and trust them, it starts to make a difference in how they feel about themselves. And once that happens, that's when we have the ability to make a difference for them.
在 Susan 的多番努力下 ，K9 Cellmates 犬只救援与训练改造计划终于在2013年6月3日正式推出。而计划最终也让监狱当局改变了想法，并给予这项计划全力支持。
Oh, of course we see changes. We see the interaction. We have inmates that are very quiet when they come in, kind of depressed. When they get in this program, K9 cellmates, they become talkative. They smile. This brings them a joy of happiness.Just having the doctor depend on them and they depending on the dog as well, it's a wonderful thing. And how they feel a sense of purpose to get back out here in our society and feel worthy of being back out there after they have made a couple of mistakes in life. So this is a wonderful, wonderful program.
从一开始的训狗计划，目前监狱当局推出的犯人改造计划已扩充到各类课程，包括辅导、面试技巧、履历书写、财务规划等等。这些计划有助囚犯们放下过去，重返社会。
Hi, I'm Brenda. Nice to meet you, Earl. Nice to meet you. Please have a seat. Oh, thank you.
课程更让囚犯学习实际应用技巧，例如模拟应征工作的情景。 对这些一直靠犯罪为生的囚犯来说，这是从未接触过的新技能。
Majority of people do want to get out and change. It's hard because you in here and you're around a whole bunch of criminals. Most of the time you talk about criminal stuff. But by having these groups, it take our minds off of it. You know, I'm thinking about I'm going to get a job when I get out. I got to pay my bills. I got to start financing. I got to save money the right way and stuff, you know? Feeling good though now, you know? Ready to get out. I'm ready to get out just to try everything that I've been taught and put it to work.
一传十，十传百，监狱当局的这项多元化改造计划在推出后广受囚犯们的欢迎，等候名单也越来越长，每天申请人数可高达60人。当然，筛选囚犯参与计划的过程也越来越严谨。趁着休息空档，囚犯通常都选择回到隔壁的营房休息。这里囚犯一周7天，每天24小时无微不至地照顾自己负责的狗儿，从喂食到洗澡到训练狗儿，狗儿几乎和囚犯形影不离。狗儿甚至可以睡在囚犯床边的笼子里。因为生活步伐变得很规律，囚犯们的情绪也变得更稳定，并且学会了付出关爱。在富尔顿监狱里，囚犯之间可以互相交流，或者看书或致电给家人朋友。他们也可以选择通过这速度缓慢的小卖部机器购物。家人可以替囚犯存放零用钱，让他们通过贩卖机购买监狱生活里需要用到的必需品，例如卫生用品、小吃或电话卡。狗儿的生活起居无时无刻都是囚犯的责任，囚犯得负责带狗儿出外散步和排便。囚犯和狗儿都非常期待和享受这1天3次的活动，即使每次只是短暂的20分钟。在监狱官的监视下，有限范围的散步对囚犯们来说是弥足珍贵的。表面上看似轻松，不过毕竟是监狱，囚犯们的生活作息无时无刻都被严密监管着。囚犯一旦违反监狱规矩，就会立即被送回富尔顿监狱主牢房，而监狱官时常进行突击检查，搜查违禁品，例如香烟、毒品、未经许可的食品，甚至自制武器。目前的学期已接近尾声，苏珊必须开始为下一期寻找适合的狗儿。富尔顿监狱对面的拯救动物组织富尔顿动物庇护所就提供了大部分的犬只。这个拯救动物组织由非营利机构 Lifeline Animal Project 管理，来者不拒，每年收留超过15000只，也就是每天40只无家可归的动物。而他们的目标是拯救所有健康和可医治的动物，为他们找到愿意收留的庇护所，从而让亚特兰大成为不杀生的社区。K9 Cellmates 犬只训练改造计划，简称 CCM， 目的是通过帮助拯救被遗弃的狗儿，让接受训狗技能的囚犯学会一技之长，增强纪律，并减少再犯罪的可能性。创办人 Susan 甚至将计划延伸至曾经参与 CCM 计划、目前已被释放的前囚犯。只要前囚犯主动联络 CCM 负责人寻求援助，例如在工作上或住宿方面遇到困难，负责团队就会尽力帮忙。
我约了一位前囚犯，他也曾经参加过 K9 Cellmate 这个 program， 现在来看一下他的状况如何。Hi Dante， How are you？
I'm doing all right。
Yeah， can I take a seat？
Yes。 I left my mother's house at the age of 13 and started committing crimes like stealing cars, armed robbing, selling drugs. So from the age of 13 to 16, I was locked up.
当时 Dante 完全没有悔过之心，十五年来一直不断犯罪，入狱无数次。他的罪行包括抢劫、偷窃、吸毒、毒品贩卖、非法持有武器等等。十五年来在监狱外的日子只有短短两年。
The neighborhood I grew up in, it went nothing but violence. Being incarcerated for so long, and the lifestyle that you were living, like that's the only thing you ever knew. How to rob, son, take, son. I didn't know how to get a 9-to-5 job.Work. I didn't know how to do nothing.
一系列的再犯罪罪行可能导致 Dante 被判入狱十一年，他甚至预计自己将被长期监禁，直到他参与了 CCM 改造计划。
Can I say that CCM really changed your whole life?
Yes, it gave me a whole different outlook on life in general. I learned how to better myself usingTry to be humble and start getting angry at anything to come my way.
通过这项计划以及 Susan 的协助 ，Dante 在六个月内成功获释。他已下定决心不再重返监狱。目前他兼职两份工作，也抽空到 CCM 举办的活动帮忙。虽然 Dante 出狱不到一个月，但 Susan 相信 Dante 是有决心悔改的。
Someone like a Dante, who never probably had made any good choices in his life because he didn't have the ability to make good choices, and certainly no ability to comprehend the fact that if he had made different choices, there might have been different outcomes in his life. And I do believe him when he says, if he hadn't been in our program and had the experiences that he experienced there, that when he got out, he would have gone back to the same lifestyle that he did.To see the fact that he wants to hold a job and he wants to do things the right way, that's huge. It's enormous.
今天 ，Susan 和团队带着狗儿 Kizzy 出门，和有意领养的公众见面。这次见面的家庭已经决定领养 Kizzy 的同伴 Jade， 现在他们正考虑是否要同时领养 Kizzy。Kizzy 的戒心较高，所以领养者带了自家的另外两只狗儿和 Kizzy 碰面，看看他们是否能和睦相处。
We met Jade at Pond City Market. We immediately like fell in love with her. So we found out a little bit about the program, which we thought was awesome. We looked online, and literally the next day we filled out the paper application.
And we also learned that Jade has a sibling, Kizzy. Mm. And we figured that it wouldn't be a good thing to separate them. Right, so right. That's why we're meeting Kizzy as well and considering Kizzy.
这次见面似乎顺利。Kizzy 和领养者的狗儿相处融洽，但是领养宠物毕竟是重大的责任，两位女士会商讨是否能负担第四只宠物才做最后决定。无论结果如何，被选中参与并完成 CCM 计划的狗儿都不会被送回庇护所，当局会安排狗儿暂住寄养者家中，直到有领养者为止。
The commitment that we make to the dogs is once they come into our program, they never go back to the shelter. They're not going to be euthanized. They're not going to go back to that terrifying environment that they came from.
虽然计划推出后的反应相当热烈，但是 Susan 觉得她做得还不够。她正努力寻找各种方式，在监狱外扩展计划。帮助 CCM 计划毕业的前囚犯远离犯罪，并减低再犯率。虽然过程挫折重重，但是 Susan 现在不再孤军作战，她背后有着多年来从 CCM 获益的各界毕业生，和她一起将计划发扬光大。
So what we're going to do is we're going to go through our normal show and tell, see where your progress is at, see what we still need to work on. Remember, we're a week and a half out.
这一期的犬只训练改造计划终于来到了尾声，
囚犯们正在为自己和狗儿的毕业表演做最后的冲刺。在过去的七周里，囚犯们一直和狗儿形影不离，一起学习，一起生活，彼此也建立了深厚的感情。一想到即将和狗儿道别，心里都感到非常的不舍。
Graduation is an extremely emotional day for all of us. I tear up talking about it because it's a tough day. We have to say goodbye to the handlers. We have to say goodbye to the dogs. And at the same time, you're celebrating the fact that these dogs who came from a very challenging environment with the possibility of not being adopted through our program, and now we know that they're being adopted and they're going to forever homes with loving families. It's a very trying, emotional day on us as part of Canine Cellmates, but more so on the handlers.
So how do you feel that he's going away?
I don't like it. I kind of got attached to him a little bit. But I mean, like I said, I like dogs. I love him. I mean, he's going to a good home. He'll be taken care of.
Do you think you will cry on that day?
I didn't want to say that on camera. But I might.
You think you will?
I don't know. I mean, I've got a bunch of tattoos. That don't mean I don't have emotions.
而囚犯 Barry 有可能在毕业典礼之前被释放。所以他和狗儿 Kizzy 能够相处的时间比预期更短，道别也比预期来得更早。
Maybe you can do it now.
Maybe I can do it now.
Yeah, why not?
What would I say to you, Mama? What would I say to you? I just want you to know that I'm gonna miss you. I love you, but I know you're going to be good, and you're going to make some family very, very happy.And just know that you're always going to be in my heart, as I know yours. That's it. We'll just get love on her and hug her and kiss her, probably. I don't know. Just love. Just want to love on her.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Class of 17 graduation!
Turn 眼间已经到了毕业典礼。在这重要的一天，领养者和参与 CCM 犬只训练改造计划的囚犯都来参与今天的活动，有些囚犯的家人也特地前来支持。
It was very exciting, really. It was good seeing all the guests, the volunteers. My dad came, so that was a special treat. It's always good to see your family when you're locked up. I was a nervous wreck. I don't know why.I mean, he's been to plenty of institutions, prisons, and jails to visit me. But I mean, this is the first time I've ever went through a program where he got to come. And I wanted him to be proud of me, which I know he was.
How you doing? You doing? Take it out.
其中有些参与计划的囚犯将在毕业典礼结束的短期内释放。正如他们十周来无微不至照顾和训练的狗儿一样，这些囚犯将有机会展开新的生活。
I'm gonna miss my dog, but I know he's going to a good place, and just the whole CCM family, I want to tell them thank you for having me, and I'm gonna try my best. I'm not perfect, but I'm gonna try my best. I know I am gonna stay out of trouble. I'm gonna do it for myself.
It actually taught me a lesson and taught me patience, really. If I can take the patience to train a dog, then I know I can take patience out there and I can do whatever I need to do out there on the streets. I'm tired of doing this. I'm tired of being locked up. All the stuff I've learned here, I plan on taking out there with me and using it.
美国最危险监狱通过人类最好的朋友来改造囚犯，并成功降低了再犯率。其实一开始美国的警察局也并不相信犬只救援与训练计划能够成功，因为在此之前很多劳改计划都失败了，出狱的犯人再犯罪的几率高达76%。但是令人难以置信的是，这项计划居然成功。通过犬只救援与训练计划的囚犯大部分都选择了放弃黑社会的身份，努力开始尝试适应正常人的生活。而原本四处流浪的狗儿也因为参与了此计划找到了新的主人。各位好，欢迎收看今天的凤凰大视野。 意大利米兰有一座叫波拉特的监狱，这里的囚犯不但不用穿囚衣，白天还能在监狱内自由地走动，因为他们也是上班一族，在对外的餐厅工作，还有机会接触来自自由世界的顾客。这里的监狱还有养马课程，监狱种种大胆的措施，最终是为了让囚犯重返社会做好准备。
意大利的米兰是一座历史古城，也是文化大都会和时尚圣地。米兰的游客络绎不绝，造成这里的犯罪率高居意大利榜首，而大部分是对游客下手的非暴力案件。波拉特监狱从外面看起来就像一座办公大楼，如果不是因为有重重的铁丝网围着，还看不出是一个囚禁犯人的地方。监狱的犯人改造计划采取了不少大胆而开明的措施，曾经吸引了不少媒体前来采访。波拉特监狱早在2001年就开始安排囚犯在监狱中工作，囚犯有穿着的自由，因为不同的工作服装上有不同的需要，这也可以让他们适应日后在监狱外的环境。
Questi sono prodotti da loro. Questa è l'esposizione.
哦，这也是其中一个一部分的犯人的改造计划之一了。这个第一牢房里面的人呢，负责呢就是做这些像是精品的东西，像是小枕头、小抱枕。也可以看到这边有很多就是意大利明星球队的一些抱枕这样子。然后他们做完之后呢，都会拿出去外面卖，或者是有些人可以上网订购这样子。Good.
Adesso andiamo più avanti che vi porto dove c'è dove producono questi gadget. This is ER.
ER. ER. ER. Emergency room.
Vengono fatte le cure più di urgenza. Poi se ci sono cose molto più gravi, i detenuti vengono scortati in ospedale. Allora, questa è l'area industriale. Poi abbiamo call center, c'è il responsabile.
Ciao.
Ciao. Piacere. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Stefano.
Oh, supervisor.
Lui è supervisor, ok.
Oh, 是这边的这个主管这样子。What do the inmates normally do over here?
Allora, qui facciamo un'attività per una importante compagnia telefonica italiana che si chiama Wind 3.Sono tutti detenuti, sono 40, e sono inquadrati con un contratto delle telecomunicazioni cooperative sociali. Hanno 5 giorni lavorativi a settimana e 2 di riposo.
Do you want a coffee?
Espresso?
原来这里不是咖啡座，而是制造自动咖啡机的工厂，而员工全是监狱里的囚犯。原来在这里工作，每个月可以得到1000欧元的奖励。更重要的是，可以学会一技之长。
So will the prisoners in this department have a higher chance to get a job when they are released?
Of course, poi abbiamo contatti con le aziende che ci danno lavoro, perché successivamente possono essere assunti da queste aziende e quindi trovare lavoro. Questo è un po'.Il completamento del progetto.
Okay, thank you.
Grazie
per la visita. 2014年，意大利各处的监狱人满为患，政府于是通过修改法令，陆续释放了10000名刑期较短的囚犯。但是，有些囚犯出狱后重蹈覆辙，又回到监狱的情况不断上演，改造计划因此迫切需要加强。波拉特监狱于是成为各监狱参考的对象。
这个波拉特监狱真的很特别，我跟你讲，监狱里面养马哎，哦，为什么会有马厩呢？嗨
，Buongiorno，Claudio，Jean，
他是这个马厩的这个主人，对对对，也是这边的主管。So Mr. Claudio，why are there horses？In the prison.
sono cavalli che arrivano da sequestri ed altre realtà. I cavalli in prigione sono stati portati per fare dei corsi con i detenuti, per insegnare ai detenuti a gestire i cavalli, ed è un aspetto molto forte quello relazionale.
Ed è stata costruita dai detenuti e me con materiali di recupero, materiali usati.
目前共有20个囚犯在照顾这些马。管理马儿非常不简单，是一门专业。为马儿刷毛、清理马蹄等等，不单单是为了卫生和清洁，也通过这些过程得到马儿的信任。马是非常有灵性的动物，有时候比人更真诚，更懂得珍惜彼此的关系。
Contropelo in senso rotatorio, piccoli cerchi. Ricordati che questo lavoro non è, hai capito? No? Perché questo massaggio porta via lo sporco e riattiva la circolazione. Sempre le due mani, sempre le due mani.
课程也教导囚犯了解马儿的习性，怎么和马儿相处，甚至是驯服它们。
Qualcuno ha voglia di darmi una mano? Mi tenete Grace mentre salgo? Grazie.
Nonostante ma di bensin wenxun, ma qui di ma, molto zai lai dao ma jiu zhi qian, mei you de dao liang hao de zhao gu, shen zhi shou dao nue dai, yin zi xing ge bao li you wei xian xing.
啊 ，Grace， tieni oppure a volte mi tengo in tasca qualcosa che so che a loro piace e li gratifico con questo anche。
其实，监狱里的囚犯和马儿都有相同的特性。囚犯和马儿日久生情，潜移默化的过程中，他们不但驯服了马，也驯服了自己。 在波拉特监狱里，还有大约100多名女囚犯。男女监狱是严格分开的，因此女子监狱有自己的另一套改造计划。
Adesso ci troviamo all'interno della sezione detentiva femminile.
来看看一下这边的女囚犯呢，平常都在做些什么？好像我们来到这个裁缝部，我们进去看一下。
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Loro sono le addette alle lavorazioni di sartoria.
Nice to meet you.
Jean.
Maria Rosa.
Madre Rosa.
Maria
Rosa. Maria Rosa.
Ah, Antonella. Sì. Siamo le
più semplici.
Siamo le responsabili del laboratorio.
无论是主管还是员工，其实他们都是女子监狱的囚犯。 波拉特监狱大约有100名女囚犯，分别关押在另一个牢房。女性囚犯的工作选择比较少，主要是缝制服装和包包，其中很多还是有名的意大利品牌。这是社区服务项目。除此之外，女子监狱内还有幼儿室和育婴室，囚犯年幼的孩子可以来拜访他们。 在这个特别的房间里，女囚犯和孩子可以加强亲子关系，让家庭结构得到保障。波拉特监狱的这些措施处处超越了传统监狱的运作模式和框框。不过，囚犯必须行为良好，得到监狱官的推荐和法庭的批准，才能转到波拉特监狱。 因为波拉特监狱的精神是以改造为主，为囚犯出狱后的生活做好准备。这些改造计划始终是在监狱中进行。接受改造的囚犯能不能重返社会？要如何让他们接触围墙外的生活呢？ 原本从事饮食业的斯维亚，2004年就开始为囚犯提供工作机会，在监狱设立饮食承包厨房。2015年，他接受监狱的邀请，进一步成立了这家高档餐厅，让囚犯接触围墙外的世界。
Nowadays, I don't know if I am not inmate because I'm working together with them for so long time. So I am used to understand their problem. I think that for one of them, for the inmates, it's very important to trust in the society, and the society is supposed to trust in them.It's like to born again when inmate go out in the end of the prison. It's just to begin again the life. And I want that cooperatives and myself too, we can help them for this walking.
适应生萨伊坐牢十多年了，原本是在监狱里承包厨房工作。他听说有这么一个新计划，马上报名参加，成为餐厅的第一个员工。
In quanto ci crediamo tutti nel progetto, io ho accettato perché per me è una cosa nuova e mi fa piacere imparare dalle persone che hanno esperienza sul campo. C'è il modo di poter andarmene avanti, cioè.
在餐厅工作和监狱里的厨房不一样，每天9点半就开始清洁工作，准备迎接午餐的客人。下午稍微休息，接着又忙碌地迎接晚餐的客人，直到晚上11点。相比之下，那些留在监狱中工作的囚犯早已回到牢房，有更多休息的时间。但是萨伊一点也不后悔这个选择。因为他在这里发现了自己的兴趣。萨伊来自摩洛哥，在意大利没有亲人，全心全意的工作成为他生活的全部。他反而担心将来有一天离开监狱的时候，没有家又没有工作，生活会成问题。未来他无法计划，也不能想太多。
这间餐厅呢即将开始营业了，现在我就要进去这整间餐厅的灵魂，也就是他的厨房，去找他们的主厨。
大卫是道地的米兰居民，早在入狱之前已经是一名厨师，曾经拜师学艺，意大利餐是他的拿手好戏。大卫动作快，话很少，对于自己的过去他不愿意说得太多，往事不堪回首，他现在宁可多谈厨艺方面的话题。
Ho tre donne in casa molto brave a cucinare. È sempre stata una passione, fondamentalmente. Me l'hanno trasmessa.
大卫也说，他的性格喜欢冒险和刺激。尽管监狱厨房的条件不能和城里出名的大餐厅相比，但是大卫喜欢把局限当成一种挑战。乐此不疲，自信满满的大卫加入餐厅之前，已经在监狱内的厨房担任厨师。听说监狱要成立对外的餐厅，他马上申请加入。
qui ho la possibilità di fare quello che dentro facevo per i miei compagni semplicemente. Qua posso tornare a farlo per la gente normale che non ha commesso il reato semplicemente.E posso farlo come piace farlo a me, come se fosse un gioco, mostrando qual è la mia vita, semplicemente.
大卫工作的时候十分投入，厨房的工作让他能发挥所长，没有时间再惹是生非。厨艺的巧手妙思让他专注自己兴趣的事，也让他尝尽了人生的各种况味。
蛮奇怪的一个融合感 ，bitter， spicy， and sweet， a little bit salty，
那个酸甜苦辣全部都尝到。The wasabi is a bit strong. I need to drink water.
哎，别怪。
哦，这有点辣。哦，喝水。
Yes,
water.
No. Yes. Try this.
用那个脏水。
Metti bocca. Mangia. Mangia. Manda giù. Manda giù. Ok. Mano. Metti in bocca. È ancora piccante? È ancora piccante?
What's that?
It's spicy now?
No. I got one question. It's like, what do you think you would become if you wasn't in the prison?
Avrei voluto le stelle Michelin, il riconoscimento delle guide.
监狱餐厅的设计别具一格，餐桌上的摆设呈现了世界各地出名的古老监狱的照片。墙上四处是以逃狱为主题的电影海报，处处提醒客人监狱需要改革的用意。餐厅在两年前开业，渐渐得到许多米兰市民的支持。尽管地点比较偏远，车程大约要半个小时，不过这里没有米兰市区的拥挤，因此每个晚上都有不少人预订。米兰市民品味高，对美食有所要求，可见餐厅有一定的水平。
哇，看到今天餐厅呢这么多人来这边捧场，就知道呢这个改造计划可以说是大成功。大家呢不会因为你的身份呢而不吃你的东西，只会因为你煮的好不好吃。所以现在呢我就要好好的享用我们主厨准备的美味佳肴了. It's
my first time here, but I was very curious to try this restaurant.
So, is your friend recommend you to come this restaurant?
It's very well known in town.
Do you like the idea of having a restaurant in the prison?
It's a very good idea because it shows that is a good things for the prisoners.
For the prison. Okay,
I think.
So is the prisoner chef better than the chef outside?
Perché no? Why not? Why not? He could have be a chef in the world, I think.
囚犯重返社会的确是一条漫长的路，一切要重新开始。监狱的规则不能用在外面的世界，新生活全都要用心的安排。尽管适应生、厨师都是服刑的囚犯，但是餐厅还需要一位有经验的经理主持大局。马西莫有二十多年的餐饮业经验，是业内的老手。他的工作包括了指导和训练这些囚犯，也就是和囚犯最近距离接触的自由人。马西莫开始的时候也感到有点担心，不知道囚犯会不会态度恶劣，难以管理。更糟的是，如果手脚不干净或者有暴力行为，那么要怎么办？但是很快的，他就发现自己的忧虑是多余的。囚犯们工作非常认真。
So can you tell me what's the feeling working with the prisoners over here, and do you feel safe?
I ragazzi che lavorano qua con me, devo dire che rispetto ai ragazzi che lavorano fuori, hanno una marcia in più che la voglia di riscattarsi. Perciò loro hanno appreso rapidamente il mestiere. Io li ho sempre trattati come collaboratori di lavoro, non gli ho fatto mai pesare il discorso che erano detenuti. Per me in questo momento sono delle persone che lavorano al ristorante, sono dei miei collaboratori. Devo dire che in questi 2 anni di apertura ho visto questi ragazzi crescere sia a livello professionale ma soprattutto a livello personale, perché hanno cominciato a prendere confidenze col mondo esterno, parlare con i clienti e vedono la realtà come fuori, e sono molto contento di questa esperienza.
另一名适应生叫迟加入这个行列，大家都叫他桑尼。桑尼是阿尔巴尼亚人，辗转来到意大里打工。由于很难找到工作，渐渐的他迷失了自己，铤而走险犯了法。还有4年就可以出狱的桑尼，也是自愿申请加入餐厅工作。
When the people are coming here from outside, are coming here to eat, they believe in us. So they are giving us a lot of things. Yeah, confidence. Like they are looking that we are this part of the world. So the prison is a part of the world. So we are human.
They don't treat you as a prisoner.
Yes. So sometimes they are curious. Like to look at us in our eyes, you know, is a little bit embarrassed in its beginning, but after it's gonna be everything okay. When they are looking at our professionality, so it's a great thing for us and for me personally. For me is so beautiful.
在餐厅工作，他每个月可以得到1300欧元的收入，学会一技之长，也为将来出狱做好准备。不过，桑尼觉得最重要的是，这样的改造计划让他找到了自己本性中的另一面。他相信自己将来不会再重蹈覆辙。
And I think that the prison take me out another part of my personality, another part of my character. Sometimes I say, like, thank you for being here and for learning this experience, because I have seen on myself so many things that when I was outside, I never thought about them. So it's a very good experience that I really need it.
餐厅的另一位员工叫史蒂芬，除了点菜、招呼客人之外，他也包办了餐厅大大小小的各种任务。史蒂芬工作十分勤快，无论是干粗活还是整理货品，他都一丝不苟，看得出他对这份工作的投入。Sì,
magari io sono stato selezionato, no? Ho cominciato dentro a lavorare in cucina interna che è gestita sempre da responsabile da BC. E dopo un percorso dentro ho avuto l'opportunità di venire al ristorante.
How many hours do you work over here and what time do you need to go back?
Lavoriamo dalle 10 fino alle 3:30-4 e stacchiamo, pausa, ricominciamo dalle 6 fino alle 6, mangiamo insieme a tutti e dopo cominciamo il servizio. Ma io non entro dentro, io torno a casa.
What? You don't stay in the prison anymore.
No.
You're living outside. So you're released. Wow. What? So can I go to your house?
Yes.
Really? Wow, that's nice.
大部分囚犯出狱后马上就回到故乡，所以很难有机会看到他们出狱后的生活。但是史蒂芬却在波拉特附近租了一所房子，继续到餐厅上班。 这一带地点偏僻，租金不高，每天步行就可以到监狱。今天早上，静伦特地来到史蒂芬的房子，打算和他边走边谈。听说
Stephen 呢就住在这里，现在找他下来。
Vai bene anche te, no?
Ai,
Ciao, ciao.
Buongiorno. Buongiorno,
buongiorno.
How are you feeling today?
Good. Today it's okay.
Okay,
it's good.
史蒂芬说，他现在住的房子也是监狱餐厅为他找的。由于不是当地人，出狱后最大的问题是无家可归。这类游民最容易被警察或移民厅官员盯上，重返监狱的可能性也最高。因此出狱那天，餐厅已经为他找到房子，还帮他付清第一个月的租金，这样史蒂芬就可以按时上班，安心地继续餐厅的工作。
So Stefano, how's your life after you are released from the prison?
Dopo che sono uscito, la vita è nuova, no? È come ricominci da capo. Ma che ti rimane sempre qualcosa lì dentro.
So why do you want to go back to the prison and work in the restaurant?
Questa è una bella domanda.Difficile da spiegare, no? Come ho detto, non so, ti abitui lì e facendo il lavoro davvero con il cuore, no? Come tutti di là, tutti lavoriamo e metti tutto, no? Per andare tutte le cose bene. E quindi non, è difficile di abbandonare quel progetto, no? E cominci a tenere anche tu a tutto che tiene di ristorante.
So Stefano, do you miss home?
Sì, mi manca. Sì, mi manca anche la mia famiglia, no? Mia sorella, mio padre. E fra un po' andrò a vederli. Adesso in agosto. Anche loro mi aspettano.
So Stefano, what's your future plans? Are you going to work here forever?
Non lo so. Per il momento non voglio pensare così lontano, no? Voglio prendere le cose piano piano.
Ok.
Stando in galera. Ciao.
Ciao, ciao, Adonis.
Alla prossima.
Okay. Bye bye.
这里是监狱。当初大家入狱的时候都沮丧悲切，想着快快离开，但没想到的是，在服刑工作的过程中却不知不觉地建立了一种归属感。这些犯人们都舍不得离开，但毕竟监狱不是家，他们总有一天会重返社会。也许在这表面看似阴郁其实充满收获的一段时光，他们会铭刻在心并心怀感恩。各位好，欢迎收看今天的凤凰大视野。挪威一直被当成是高福利高幸福感的社会。奥斯泰哈监狱位于挪威的西南部，是一座小岛监狱。这里没有高墙，没有围栏，更没有持枪的警卫，反而更像是一座适合度假的小岛。这里的监狱以更人性化的制度努力培养囚犯们的工作技能，希望他们重返社会时能有一技之长，而不是在监狱中虚度年华。
挪威位于斯堪的纳维亚半岛，是以盛产石油和天然气致富的北欧国家。根据2017年世界幸福报告，挪威的幸福指数在155个国家中排名第一，是最幸福的国度。这说明挪威在满足公民需求、生活质量和潜力发展等方面做得最好。作为高度重视人权的国家，挪威的监狱以人性化的设施和制度闻名，但同时也被人调侃为诱惑犯罪的天堂。
Do the officers carry weapon in the cell?
No, we don't carry weapon at all.
How do you protect yourself?
Mainly by talking to inmates.
奥斯泰监狱是一个小岛监狱，面积大约9公顷，相等于13个足球场的面积。这里囚禁了26名因犯了企图谋杀、强奸及运毒等罪行而被判入狱的囚犯，并由6名狱警轮班掌管。但这监狱小岛的四周并没设任何高墙及围栏， 因此看起来一点都不像一座监狱，甚至常有当地居民及游客到小岛附近垂钓。一般探访监狱，我们都必须穿过几米高的高墙、厚重的铁门、上缴一切电子设备及办探监手续等等才能入闸。但在这里，我们不需经过重重关闸就能登陆，而且迎接我们的更是身穿便衣、面带笑容的狱警。
Mm-hmm. I'll bring you for a walk mm-hmm. around the island mm-hmm. so you can see what there is to see.
Oh, awesome.
And here's Hanne. Mm-hmm. She is Wachsmeister. That means she's in charge of all the activities that inmates join into, and the buildings and supplies and mostly everything on the island.
Oh, so she's a mother.Of the island.
Yeah, you can say that.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
she would like that.
Okay.
But she knows all the details, so I think I'll let her bring you on the tour.
Okay, hello.
Hello.
I meet you at the jetty.
Yeah. Yes.
So,
Hanna 是奥斯泰监狱的负责人，但在担任这项职位前，她其实是一名厨师。除了打理自家餐厅以外，她还在各媒体分享烹饪心得。更在2006年获得挪威年度最佳厨师的荣誉。
Why giving up your restaurant, being a chef, and come here to be in charge here?
Well, I used to have inmates employed as trainees mm-hmm. in my restaurant, so I have been in contact with a person for many, many years. The person who had this job before me, he asked me, and I asked him.Do you think that I can manage this job? And he said, yes, I think so. And I thought, okay, if you say so, I
do it. Let's try.
Yeah.
挪威的监狱乐于聘请有社会经验的人士加入囚犯改造的工作，这样能避免囚犯与社会脱节，也让囚犯们能在出狱后更快适应民情，回归社会。
It's like a little...island with their own identity, a little society here.
Yes.
So you just said that you produce your own chicken.
Yes, we have chicken mm-hmm. and we produce eggs for the inmates.
For the food?
Yes.
I kind
you
of
smell,
smell yes, I can smell the chicken, yes.
Yes.
How many eggs do they produce in a day?
40.
40? So many?
Yes.
除了鸡只以外，这小岛监狱还养了羊和猪等牲畜。这样一来，监狱不但能自供食材，也能让囚犯有照顾牲畜的机会，从而培养他们的耐性及责任感。
他们这里还养了两只阿巴嘎，这两只阿巴嘎呢，其实是一个非常可爱的一种宠物。然后这个宠物其实在这里啊，其实就是让这些囚犯有多一点的机会去照顾一个动物，让他们可以有一个有些时候不想跟人说话，或者是没有倾诉的对象的时候，可以跟他们说多一点话。这个也是一个治疗的方式，让他们有更多的空间，或者是有一个对象可以让他们说出他们心里想说的话。
Okay, so this is the greenhouse.
This is the greenhouse where we have small tomatoes and big tomatoes. And want to come、
cherry、
in here、
tomatoes.
And shall we taste?
Yes, please.
Yes.
I love cherry tomatoes.
Yes.
You just eat like that?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's so sweet. It's very sweet.
Very sweet.
If I'm here for one day, the tomatoes will be gone. So who take care of the tomatoes?
The inmates. We have one inmate that take care from the spring.
So there's only one in charge?
Yes, in here. Yeah. Sometimes he gets help.
So does he get paid?
Yes.
Averagely, how much does he get in a day?
A normal day work, they get 62 or 65. Yeah. And when you put in...Extra. It's almost up to 100 kronas a day.
挪威人有着很不同的用餐时间。每天上午11点便是监狱的午餐时间，晚餐时间则是下午3点。 而上午8:15至下午2:30，则是囚犯们的工作时间。这里的囚犯能自行选择工作，由照顾牲畜、种植、烹煮到建筑等等。无论囚犯是擅长粗工或细活，都能在这里找到自己的发挥空间。没有经验的囚犯也能得到免费的工作培训。奥斯泰监狱共有6名女囚犯，他们被安置在主要大楼的女子监舍，而剩下的20名男囚犯则被分派到5间4人同住的木屋监舍。
哇哦！Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
So this is your house?
Yeah.
Wow. Do you want to bring me around your house? Show me your house?
I want to show you your house?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
This is your room.
Wow. This is very cozy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. It's nice to me. Do it my own style, so.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah.
除了固定的工作及用餐时间以外，监狱方并没规定其他的作息时间。囚犯们能自由地在外活动或待在监舍里休息。所有的生活作息、监舍卫生打理都必须与同居的伙伴们协商。这样的团体生活有助于囚犯们适应群体生活，释放后便能更容易与社会接轨。在这里，囚犯们能自由地选择工作，他们可选择自己熟悉的工作或学习新的技能。在得到相关的职业培训后，囚犯们能在最低的监督下自行操作各种工程车辆及工具，如挖土机、推土机、卡车等，甚至是被称为最危险的工具——电锯。
So this is for fire.
This is for fire, and some of these bushes we use for feed to the animals around on the island.
Oh.
Yes.
So it's good food for the animals.
Yes. We must also take down because it's growing so fast on this island. So if you not take down, it will be like a jungle after a few
too much.
Years.
Yes. Too much. What were you doing before you came here? I mean.Do you have a job?
Yes, before I was a truck driver. Yes.
But I'm sure as a driver, you wouldn't know how to use a chainsaw, right?
No. So that is what I have learned inside here. Mm-hmm. We had a course.
让囚犯们自由地选择工作是监狱动态安全策略的一部分，因为当罪犯们全心投入到一件事情中，就很少再去和狱警或狱友发生冲突。挪威刑事改造的原则是，监狱应该是限制自由的地方，仅此而已。因此，监狱方也很注重囚犯们与家人的关系。监狱公厕外就设有公共电话供囚犯们使用。任何囚犯只需事前注册并预购电话费，便能随时与亲友联系。挪威的刑罚制度强调人道、人文和建设性。希望借此让罪犯们能够体会到社会对他们的宽容，从而真心忏悔自己的罪行。因此，这里的囚犯在工作时间以外，也能参与各种休闲活动，像烹饪、打牌或一些球类运动。其实，监狱方鼓励囚犯们参与户外活动，除了是让他们打发时间外，也能预防囚犯们患上季节性情绪失调，简称 SAD 的情绪病。SAD 的症状是焦虑、疲惫、悲伤等等，是北欧一带很普遍的病症。因为北极圈漫长冬天的关系，阳光不足被认为是 SAD 的主因，因此鼓励囚犯多参与户外活动是预防 SAD 的好方法。监狱方相信，让囚犯们接触大自然，也能让他们暂时摆脱社会压力，学习珍惜生活中其他更加重要的事物，例如人际关系和团队协作等等。
I realize that the inmates here can do well, like what they want to do, right?
Well, they can't run away from the island, and they cannot treat each other with disrespect. So they have to be polite, and they have to
do the job they are supposed to do and follow the rules.
Okay. What makes you so sure that they won't run away?
Because they really want to stay here. They have applied. Mm-hmm. And they actually do want to spend time here and to go to job and to school and live a good life when they are in prison.
其实这里的囚犯并不是一开始便可在奥斯泰监狱服刑的。所有的囚犯入狱时都必须先在高戒备监狱服刑，直到刑期剩下3至5年，才可申请到像奥斯泰监狱一样的低戒备监狱服刑，为日后重返社会做好准备。挪威的总人口大约为520万，却拥有高达42所监狱，而与挪威人口相近的新加坡却只有14所监狱。这除了是因为挪威拥有特殊的地形及低人口密度以外，也因为挪威监狱秉持着一项就近原则，允许挪威的囚犯在离家最近的监狱服刑。监狱当局相信，这样不但能增加囚犯在自己社会自新的机会，也方便家人前往探访。由于挪威的囚禁方式是分阶段式进行的，因此挪威刑事改造局得设立不同类型的监狱关押囚犯。犯人往往先从高戒备监狱开始服刑，然后改造局会考虑是否把犯人送往低戒备监狱。行为良好的囚犯还能申请到更开放的中途之家服刑，这有助于协助囚犯从监禁逐渐过渡到完全自由的生活。今天一早，我们便从卑尔根市中心驾驶20分钟来到卑尔根北部的高戒备监狱。电网、铁栏、6米多高的围墙，在这里我们终于见到了符合我们认知的高戒备监狱。那在这看似戒备森严的卑尔根监狱里，是否还贯彻重视人权和以人为本的原则呢？
一来到高戒备监狱的时候，哇，我才真正的看到监狱。因为一在大门口的时候就看到很高的围墙，这样才像一个监狱吧。但是一走进监狱之后呢，又发现哎，奇怪，这个监狱怎么跟我的想象的监狱又不一样？因为其实我们常常看到的监狱啊，都是长得蛮高的嘛，那个建筑都是高高的，但是它这些都是蛮矮的。
Good morning, good morning, Mofrid.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Nice to see you.
Welcome to Bergen Prison.
Thank you, thank you. It was very high security when we were outside.
Yeah.
The wall is so high, I was thinking if I'm going to come here, I will never get out.
Oh no, you can't.
Yeah, never.
No one has ever escaped this prison.
卑尔根监狱面积约8公顷，大约有12个足球场大小，关押了258名囚犯，是挪威最大的监狱之一。挪威监狱并没把不同类别的囚犯分开囚禁。这里有因犯了交通违规、逃税等轻罪而被判入狱的犯人，也有犯了强奸、贩毒、企图谋杀等重罪的囚犯。有别于奥斯泰小岛监狱，这里的每一道门都是安检门，需有狱警的门卡才能通过。入闸前必须在入口处办理探监手续，并把手机及相机等存放在寄物柜里。
This is where the cells are.
This looks like what I imagined.
Yes.
The cells are all together and there's more cells on top.
Yes, and there's even more on the second floor going that way. So it's a lot of inmates here. Okay. So this is an ordinary cell. This is what it looks like. If you close the door, you can see there are no handles.
Oh,
and they are here 23 hours a day, perhaps, in this block.
They have their own bathroom,
The old bathroom?
Yes, yeah. Everyone has the old bathroom.
It saves them from a lot of work because they can be able to take care of their own hygiene.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So we don't have to take them to the showers or toilets or things like that.
Ah.
So it's very effective.
来到俗称黑房的最高戒备牢房，也并没有想象中那么阴森可怕，因为牢房里仍设有一个很小的窗口，被关在黑房里的囚犯仍可看见户外。挪威对囚犯不是以惩罚为目的，而是提倡人道、人文和建设性的刑法制度，着重于让囚犯找回良知及其对社会的感恩。
Do the officers carry weapon in the cell?
No, we don't carry weapon at all.
No, no weapon?
No.
How do you protect yourself?
Mainly by talking to mm-hmm. inmates.
But if they want to do harm the
yes.
officers, what precautions do you have?
Then I would always think of my own security first, and I would try to seek help from colleagues, and then we would try to put the inmate on the floor and then get him out of the situation that way.
By using bare hands?
Bare hands, yes. We believe that it would increase any conflict if we had it on ourselves all the time.
You have more conflict?
Yes.
挪威一般给囚犯判刑的刑期都很短，平均不超过八个月。90%的刑期都在一年以下，一般普通的囚犯会被安排入住七人单位。所谓七人单位，指的是七名囚犯共用一个活动空间和厨房，但个别的囚犯仍有属于自己的单人牢房。
They eat together, they make food together, and they watch television together.
Oh, they cook themselves.
Yeah.
So someone needs to know how to cook.Out of the seven of them.
Yes.
If all seven don't know how to cook,
then they have to learn.
Then they have to learn.
They will need to learn.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. So they are provided with the knives, scissors.
Yeah.
They have like this. Mm-hmm. It's not dangerous. And the biggest knife, they can't take it away.
Okay, okay.
They have to use it here. And that's the only knife they can get.
单人牢房的面积约15平方米，可说是比一般学生宿舍的房间来得更大更舒适。别于其他国家的监狱，挪威监狱在设计及装潢上不会给人一种阴森森的压抑感，取而代之的是偏暖的灯饰及简约的装潢。
So what is this place here?
This is a recreation center for, mm-hmm. for inmates. Mm-hmm. So they can be here together. And we have activities here. Uh-huh. This is the most popular.
The table soccer?
Yeah.
And they can watch a DVD?
Yeah.
They can watch TV, DVD.
They can go outside on the porch.
挪威的囚犯们不必穿囚服，住的都是小单间。监狱里还设有文化中心、图书馆、健身房、陶艺房等，因为监狱方希望所有的囚犯最终都能回归社会，过回正常的生活。
This is a small apartment、mm-hmm. where inmates can have overnight
with the family.
Yes, they can.、Oh. If they are a parent, they can meet the child and another grown up.
Any inmate can apply if they have small children,、mm-hmm. but it's very restricted. It's so if you're a sexual offender, things will be difficult.
Violence.、Yeah.
So it's quite a nice area.
Very nice. Is there a restriction of how many hours they can have with their family?
If you are allowed, you can have your family stay here for 24 hours. Normal visiting time is 1 hour per week,、mm-hmm. but we try as much as we can to extend it.、Mm-hmm.
挪威刑事改造的原则是，监狱应该是限制自由的地方，仅此而已。罪犯除了待在监狱里，应该享有和外面普通人一样的所有权益。监狱方欢迎囚犯的家人前来探访，提供这样的单位是不想囚犯与家人，尤其是和儿女的关系因囚禁而疏离。 但是要维持更人性化的监狱需要庞大的资源。根据2013年的分析报告，挪威监狱需花费440亿挪威克朗来维修国内所有的监狱，而工程进行时还需要临时关闭部分监狱，因此挪威面临短期牢房短缺，超过1000名犯人排队等候坐牢。
Norway is renting a prison in Netherlands, and we have 242 inmates there at any time. We ask inmates if they want to do their time there, and some say yes, and they've been transferred to Netherlands for a period of time.
I didn't know you can rent a prison.
No, I didn't either before it happened.
Yeah,
and it's quite extraordinary because it's in Netherlands, but within the prison there is the Norwegian's
community.
And the law is Norwegian law.
Even the officers?
The officers are from Netherlands. Mm-hmm. The governor and the assistant governor are Norwegians. Mm-hmm. So it's run like a Norwegian prison.
按照挪威与荷兰的协议，双方将签约5年。期间，挪威还会翻新旧的牢房，而被转移的囚犯在刑满释放前会被送回挪威。数据显示，挪威只有将近20%的囚犯会在2年内重返监狱，但美英两国却高达70%。这真的是挪威以更开放性的监狱制度换来的成果吗？今天，苏志成回到了奥斯泰监狱，换上了厨师服，打算和 Hannah 及这里的囚犯厨师 Sondre 联手制作挪威的传统香肠，并尝试了解开放式监狱对囚犯的影响。
This meat has been fermenting for like 6 weeks now.
But it's raw.
Yes, but it's lamb.
Lamb.
So it's okay. Okay. It's no pork or something. Smell it first.
Never smelled this before.
No. You know, it's the same way of when people are making kimchi. You make the cabbage with the salt and put it together with no air. So it's the same principle. But we do it in meat, with meat.
挪威香肠是非常古老的食物生产和肉食保存技术。香肠使用山羊肉搅碎成泥状后，与蒜蓉及野花香料混合，再灌入以海草制成的肠衣。Sondre 也是在这监狱里才有机会学到如何制作这挪威的传统美食。
Okay, so this is the traditional way of doing it, and you have to use a lot of muscle. Oops, like that. And as you see, there's quite a lot of muscle power.
Yes.
This is why the men used to do this back in the days.
How long do you stay here? I mean, the imprisonment.
I got 3.5 years sentence.
Okay, so 1.5 years in the high security?
No, I was in the high security for only 4 months.
Oh, 4 months that you came here?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's the great thing about it. If you show good behavior and will to change, then they put you out there as fast as possible.
挪威监狱给予典狱长管理权限的空间很大，以方便在执行上能有更大的弹性。表现良好的囚犯不但有机会调往更开放的低戒备监狱，挪威的法律甚至有一个称为刑度打折的制度。监狱能按照监狱行刑法给予裁量权，让原有稳定工作的受刑人只需服满2/3的刑期即可出狱。而对于像 Sondre 一样没有稳定工作的囚犯，监狱方一样会尽力协助。
All right, so you came here to the island. What do you think it will help you?
all the things that you do here, the things that you are going to do on the outside. Mm-hmm. We clean our rooms, our house every day, mm-hmm. and we are working like this, learning mm-hmm. new things, and mm-hmm. we are taking education. I think it will really help me when I come outside to stop being a criminal. Mm-hmm. In the high security, I would have been friends with another criminals that has been in for years or maybe many times, and they would probably tell me that I would make a better criminal and tell me and give me contacts in them.
And place. Help them to commit crimes again?
Yeah, and it would probably have ended with me become a criminal for the rest of my life, creating a criminal instead of creating another human that can help society.
Mm-hmm. Will the prison help you, like, to get a kickstart?
Yeah, they're gonna help me find a job. They have a lot of contacts around in Norway, and they're gonna tell them that I want a job there. I just have to apply. Mm-hmm. And when I get a job, I go up to the apartment that they have, and then I start working from there. And
awesome.
It's a great system.
其实许多重返监狱的囚犯都是社会中没有稳定收入和生活的人，挪威监狱处处为囚犯着想，通过教育、工作及环境让他们获得信心，自然能减低囚犯重返的可能性。奥斯泰监狱的设计主张营造一种身为社会一部分的环境，监狱方相信监狱内部和外部世界之间的差异越小，犯人出狱之后就越容易融入自由。因此监狱为囚犯提供了一切选择，他们可以选择想从事的工作、想参与的活动及想吃的食物。监狱方甚至允许囚犯们乘船到对岸的超市购买日用品或食材自己下厨。
This is a trust, because right now there is no guards with us or anything. Mm-hmm. We're just walking to the store shopping like a normal man.
Yes.
And there's a lot of trust in that.
Yes.
Yeah. The thing that keeps us mm-hmm. from just walking away right now
yeah.
is the fact that we're actually quite happy where we are. Mm-hmm.
监狱方对于囚犯们有着绝对的信任。奥斯泰监狱的狱警表示，他们从不担心有人会在途中逃狱。若真的发生逃狱事件，监狱方只希望该名囚犯能拨个电话报平安，免得监狱方担心他的安危。
挪威的监狱为人们带来了对一座监狱新的理解，囚犯只在于限制人身的自由，而不是剥夺人权。给犯错的人多一点爱，多一些耐心，指引他们去做正确的事，而不要一直指责他们所做错的事情。各位好，欢迎收看今天的凤凰大视野。在台湾彰化监狱，囚犯被称为同学，当局希望通过艺术治疗和熏陶，让他们情绪上有所抒发，心灵上有所寄托。在狱方所成立的如林工坊，囚犯不仅能够接触并传承传统工艺，他们还可以学习一技之长，为出狱后铺路。
近年来，台湾监狱正面临过度拥挤的现象，全台湾的监狱只能容纳约56000人，可是实际收押的人数却高达约63000名。数据也显示，囚犯出狱后再犯率竟高达75%。为了遏制囚犯再犯罪，台湾矫正署积极采取应对方案，近年来还以较人性化计划来管理受刑人。
这是法务部矫正署彰化监狱，在这里头呢，总共有2500名收容人，非常有趣，他们不叫犯人，而是收容人。
彰化监狱主要收押的是青年囚犯，不过青年囚犯人数却不到200名。因为全台湾监狱面对拥挤的现象，所以这里也收容了年纪较大、刑期7年以上有期徒刑的受刑人。在彰化监狱收容人当中，吸毒犯和毒品犯就占了一半的囚犯人口。
营长你好。
好，你好，你好，你好，你好。
我是彰化的主持人。
你好，你好，欢欢迎莅临彰化监狱。这栋大楼是我们彰化监狱的戒护大楼。
我第一个印象是，所谓森严呐，
是要经过我们所称的叫做三道门，这一道门打开要关了以后，这边才能够打开。
对，绿灯就是可以进。
对，绿灯就可以，就可以。
谢谢。
那要到经过第三道门以后，才能进入我们的我们所称的戒护区。哦，好，来，哎，请
走。所以它会响，是因为探测到有电器，是因为它会发出讯号。
对，它发出讯号就警告，哎，有手机就进入到我们的，就这边平常是不能有手机进来的。哦，在我左手边就是我们这边叫高度管教区，那我右手这边叫青年管教区，那在两栋之间呢，就有一个花园，我们也平常也都在家把它整理，整理的看起来就让人觉得心情会好一点了。
我在做资料搜查的时候，我就发现有不同的叫法，包括了收容人、受刑人跟更生人啊。所以这三个不同的叫法有什么差别？
那个受刑人就是他在监狱里面服刑者，那如果是更生人的话，就是这些受刑人他已经出监了，出到监狱外，我们就统称为更生人。
收容人呢？
因为在监所里面有很多被收容人，比如说有受刑人、有在押被告等等，我们就把这些人统称为收容人。
彰化监狱总面积13公顷，所收容的2500名受刑人都收监于两栋大楼内的隔离设防。
所以这是什么地方？
一间大型设防，面积约16平方米，可容纳7到12名受刑人；而一间约8平方米的小型设防，可容纳3到5名受刑人。
这可以睡到4个人，人少的话就睡3个人。哦。我们是希望呢，受刑人在服刑之中呢，有床铺可以睡觉。以前的话，没有床铺之前呢，那受刑人是睡在这个地板上，
硬的地板、啊。
对，硬，但是底下会有一个垫背，
连小毛巾都折得好整齐，很干净。
基本上，我们住在这一栋，我们叫小单位的受刑人，他们都是要穿着背心。每一个受刑人基本上都是要工作。等一下我们看到的就是会在工厂里面。我们叫做作业，
这是第一工厂。
这边是我们工厂受刑人工作的场所。
每个受刑人被分配到不同的单位，有的是负责监狱内的清洁或饮食，有的被派到监狱内的13个小型工房里工作。为了方便管理，彰化监狱把做同样作业的收容人分配到同一间设防。在彰化监狱自营作业的13个小型工厂当中，以花灯制作最颇负盛名。彰监花灯已成为业界品牌。
哇！我们可以制作大型的花灯，好像这么高的。
哦。这么高的都可以做得到。
然后是这种要做组合，作为在这边做一做，然后运到外面去把它组合起来。
他们做了这些手工艺品之后是有收入的吗？
有收入，有收入。那他们的收入的话，就是依照我们的法律规定呢，他们要提拨一定的比例给犯罪被害人。那扣掉这些比例以后呢，才是我们的受刑人他自己的所得。哦，
自己有一些收入，也同时可以回馈社会。
是。
原来每个收容人在服刑期间参与劳动，都可赚取工资。依法规定，收容人只能领取作业收入的37.5%，其余等同受刑人缴税机制，也用在改善全体受刑人的生活。依照他们可领取的劳作金，花灯制作单位的受刑人在监狱内也算是高所得族群，属于专业师傅级的受刑人，每个月可领到台币30,000多元的劳作金。除了花灯制作，彰化监狱的囚犯改造计划很多都跟文化传统艺术有关。
我们总共有大概10多种这种艺术的团体，啊，这只是其中的几项。
怎么会有这样子的一种概念跟想法，要用艺术教化这里的 受刑人？
因为我们是了解，在受刑人在艺术他的创作或他的学习这个过程呢，他本身就是一种教育，一种治疗。那我们希望透过这一种受刑人在学习这个艺术之中呢，他能够缓和他的情绪，那只要他心情定下来的话，他就会用心去学习这些技艺。
虽然之前已经开办了艺术文化课程，为了更加推广传统技艺学习活动，彰化监狱成立了儒林学院。当局考虑到，纵使收容人无法学好技能，也至少能在学习过程中让平时无缘接触艺术的群体有机会领悟到艺术的美好。服刑将近六年的黄福天就是个例子，他起初也对南管音乐没有任何兴趣。
进来服刑被判了二十几年，然后生活上就没有目标，日子在过好像行尸走肉啊，也不知不觉监方就举办那个南管班啊，让我进入到南管班，跟每一位同学相处得很融洽，因慢慢的那个服刑上就好像找到另外一个目标。
在彰化监狱十多个艺术团体中，传统艺术的居多。彰化县文化局把南管和北管作为彰化县的重要传统音乐，为了推广传统音乐，彰化县文化局还特别聘请专业老师到这里指导。
我觉得他们很有规矩，比我们外面的那些还更有纪律，而且他们都很自发性的去学习这个东西。
我在这边也要感谢我们那个南管班的吴敏翠吴老师，让我能够重新找到我的人生，也让我脱胎换骨。
我对他们的背景啊什么，其实我不会了解太多，我只是用一种朋友的心态，还有引导一些观念啊，让他们用这种音乐去把他的心情所疏解一下啊，所以我觉得我跟他们之间就好像变成是朋友这样子。
学习到那个南管乐，心情上真的轻松很多，我已经爱上了琵琶了。
彰化监狱希望透过共同负责的公益作业，让受刑人不仅加强他们的团结合作意识以及沟通能力，让他们有一技之长，同时也让彰化传统工艺能够传承下去。除了制作花灯，收容人也可在受刑期间学习葫芦雕刻以及制作荞麦面等的手工艺品和美食。为了保存濒临失传的传统工艺，彰化监狱积极聘请国宝级师傅走进监狱教导受刑人。这些师傅在监狱内的儒林工坊培育出不少传统工匠，就这样，彰化监狱逐渐成为守护各项传统艺术的堡垒。
把这个线给它勾出来，
先勾出一个，
对，勾出一个线，然后你要很稳的割下来，不能断。
好，
试试看，顺着这一条线。
好，
你要抓好，你要抓好，然后割下来要割给它顺。
好，我好像不太顺，就是能够感觉到它的那个阻力，是不是？
对对对，因为刚学都会这样，刚学都会这样，
手会抖抖的。
对，慢慢就会可以了。嗯。
因为都要慢慢做，你做快的话就不好看，就会多臭的。
对，那眼睛也要很定，心要静下来，才能够慢慢的把这个做出来。
你可以试试看。
李玉洲在这里雕刻葫芦已有五年了， 单单学习雕刻葫芦的基本功就花了一年。不过因为自己被判十年刑期，李玉洲打算用剩下的受刑时间用心掌握葫芦雕刻的技巧。
当初你怎么会特别对这个感兴趣？
因为当初我参加技训班的时候，我第一次看到这个东西，我想说怎么这么漂亮，能够做出这么漂亮的，对，然后自己也想要说投入这份艺术，所以就用心下去学。
学的时候刚开始遇到什么样的困难？
刚开始就是很挫折啊，就是譬如好像你割这个线呢，
是
师傅他们都割得很顺啊，我就是怎么割这样，就是不知道问题到底在哪边这样。师傅就说再多多练习没关系啊，他们也是这样过来的，对，只要有用心想要学都一定能够学会。对，
雕刻一个葫芦可耗上一到两个星期，一不小心葫芦刻坏了就得报销，然后从头做起，所以这里的每个师傅都非常专心和谨慎。
从头到尾你要想好怎么去做，然后慢慢的做这样，因为你坏掉了这个就没有用了。
那以后你会想要做这方面的老师，或者教别人怎么做？
教别人怎么做是后面有新进的同学，我们就会耐心的教他，希望把这份工艺把它传承下去。
像这里许多的工匠一样，41岁的刘炳阳原本没机会接触，也没兴趣认识或欣赏传统艺术。对他而言，学习狮头彩绘原本是个打发时间的方法，但是4年下来，他不仅对狮头彩绘产生了兴趣，更对自己的作品有了一定的要求。
慢慢画，就越画越有兴趣，你画一画会有成就感，得到了会不一样的感觉。
入狱2年后，刘炳阳被安排学习狮头彩绘。当时因为被判贩卖毒品服刑25年，他难以平复自己的情绪，又挂念家中的母亲和妻小，所以学习过程并不顺畅。
很困难，很困难，静不下来啊，
心静不下来。
对啊。
为什么会这样子呢？
因为刚关没多久啊。
所以要做好这个跟心态也很有关系。
心态也有关系，就像在修行一样。
是。
对啊。
后来你觉得自己怎么越做越好？
慢慢克服啦，想要把它做好，其实做好就会很有那种成就感，最起码我自己去克服它了。心要先静下来。哎呀，好像我要这一块，我就下去画啊，不用怕。
这个好细哦。
对啊，就是笔的提顿的问题。
我听在耳里，感受在心里，我觉得他们已经变成了是我的老师，在循循善诱，告诉我说你要有更多的耐性，你要更加的宽容。为了多了解台湾监狱的矫正计划以及教化方案，我们来到了台湾法务部矫正署的总部，见一位关键人物。您是黄署长吗？
哎，你好，你好，你好，
你好，你好，我是钟伟。
你好，你好，你好，幸会，幸会。
我觉得矫正署这个名称，对我来说是蛮有意思的。
是
怎么样从监狱变成矫正这样子的一种观念呢？
它本来矫正机关，其实我们的理念都一直在改变啊。过去是比较封闭，也比较威吓型，那么慢慢走向比较教化。那我们这个矫正署，这个署徽有两把钥匙
啊，
一把是打开心灵之窗，把我们收容人的内心能够把它打开来，让它重新的再开始，另外一把是开启希望之门，也就是说，从我们矫正机关在里面执行，经过我们教化的洗涤以后，那么能够让它走向光明的社会，这个是我们
矫正署总部处处可见受刑人经过矫治教化后的成品。这里每个摆设品都来自台湾各个监狱，他们不只是透过收容人的技能、创意和努力所制作的工艺品或产品，也是地方传统文化成功传承下去的标榜和证据。
这个是我们一般的那个饮料的罐子。
哦，那个铝罐。
哎，对，啊，其实它是从资源回收里面去做的。
对对对，
这个狗，这个是牙签呢，
是
这个10,000多只牙签呢，哇，这个是在我们花灯比赛的时候呈现的，我们在过年期间，台湾各个庙宇里面哈，他都会委托我们来做一些花灯，嗯，我们桃园监狱啊、台北监狱，他都会做陶艺的，我们所有监狱，它一间都有一个特色。我们每个单位都有它的特色啦，在矫正教育里面，技能训练也只有一环，好，各项厨艺也都只有一环，它还有各项的，包括亲子教育，包括生命教育等等，最主要就是我们针对它个案需要来做安排它的课程，好，平常有固定的时间啊，固定的课程的安排，好，啊，有的一般的课程走完以后，他会去技能训练的工厂。他这个有时候长期培养，有的要做5-6年才可能会有成熟的技术。
在做这些规划的当儿，你们会碰到一些什么样的挑战吗？
哦，那当然会有啦，因为我们监狱本身过去比较新的、新后期建的都倒还有，比较传统、比较旧的，当然各项设施就比较不足啦。
在法务部矫正署的体制下，台湾监狱执行着监禁、沉淀、蜕变以及复归的四大功能。也就是说，狱方并不只是戒护管理受刑人，同时也要让他们反省思考过错，让他们接受教化和技能训练，最后再让他们顺利返回并且融入社会。
我们都是以用爱为出发点在教导他们，我们其实矫正工作其实是我们司法体系最后一环，就执行嘛，就是侦查、审判、执行，我们是要做最后的一个把关者。我们希望让我们整个社会经过我们对这一段时间对受刑的教化啦，或是技能训练啦，给他顺利回归社会，能够减少各项危害，更能够让社会更祥和、更安全，这个才是我们的最高的一个使命。
自2017年6月起，台湾矫正署开始实施自主监外作业，让一些即将刑满的受刑人在无人监管的情况下出外工作。获选的受刑人得入监服刑3个月以上，服刑期间行为稳定，而且1年后将提报假释或刑满出监。目前，台湾监狱有82位受刑人在监狱外工作。到了年底，参与人数将提高到250位。今天，军委陪几位受刑人一同到离彰化监狱不远的养老院兼休闲农场。
里面的工作性质就是我们那在烧的那个金子嘛，整天就是折那种金子而已。外面你可以接触的工作，水电，然后我们电工。还有那个泥水工都可以接触到，嗯，啊，农业可以接触到，嗯，啊，我们在那边也是比较有这个荣幸，都认识这个老板啊，他让我们工作，让我们自己看你有什么技能，他就让你自己去发挥技能。
跟监狱内作业相比，监狱外工作的重复性较低，虽然工作时间比较长，让人感到比较劳累，不过辛劳的作息却能让他们更容易跟社会重新接轨。慈恩养老院是个福利机构， 所以在缺乏技工、财力有所局限的状况下，能够跟彰化监狱合作聘用受刑人来帮忙工作，是个双赢方案。每天开工之前，参与自主监外作业的受刑人会先向工作场地的主管确认当天的工作，然后自行安排跟规划。
全部都是他们建的，
整个上面的结构哈，从这从头到尾都是他们盖的，而且可以注意到，其实他们对这个丈量的精准度是已经是生意班业界在做的，其实已经达到那个水准了。
所以我现在看他工作的速度这么快，是因为他有一定的经验，而技巧也非常的熟练。
对对对，他透过他这样的经验，可以帮助我们深藏农场哈，可以大概一些设施，然后我们的这些身障的小朋友也可以学到一技之长。他们也会有一种回馈的心态，就是说我以前可能做了一些错误的事情，现在哈，他有要回馈社会，然后要照顾这些身障的小朋友，所以他们其实跟他们互动起来是会感，我们会感觉到他们特别照顾他们。
我们这边是比较特殊，因为特殊是因为我们跟慈恩这个社会福利机构合作，那我们会洽询慈恩这边的一个需求。他们最主要是看护的工作，不过我们那边没有看护的证照，所以说我们就看他们需要农场的铁工的，所以说我们就从他专长、监内表现，还有家庭的支持度来挑选这个人、这些人。那我们抱出一个信念，就是说帮助一个受刑人，就是帮助一个家庭。我们不只帮助陈永富而已，他整个家庭我们帮助到了。
35岁的陈永富之前因为跟妻子离异感到沮丧，结果吸毒，然后肇事逃逸被抓。他家中只有年迈的母亲和6岁的儿子，所以陈永富一入狱，家庭经济变得更加拮据。参与自主监外作业，让他有机会赚取更多工资。他希望所赚来的钱，在他出狱之后，可以减轻家庭的经济负担。
家里面经济情况都不好，妈妈又没有办法工作，又老了 啊，一个小孩子而已，还在读幼稚园而已啊，所以会担心啊，担心他们钱不够用啊。
31岁的周贝奇出狱已有3-4年了，虽然他在入狱之前已经懂得焊接等技术，不过在监狱里面参与制造花灯的工程中，他把自己对焊接的认识和技术提升为一门艺术。现在他还能够靠自己制作花灯的工艺能力谋生。
这边，
周贝奇先生。
老师好，
这么见外。周同学你好。
你好你好，
你叫我杨同学。
啊，杨同学。
所以这是你的工作室？
对，做小型的时候是在这边的。
平时在这边会做什么样的工作？
家里是做玻璃跟铝窗的。如果有一些小型的花灯的话，也是可以在这里完成。
所以这就是教你怎么做会这些工作的老师吗？
对对对，良师益友。
良师益友。
良师益友。
喜欢在工作环境里投降。
听蔡导师说，周贝奇之所以会入狱，其实是受朋友所累。当时刚考取驾照的他，应朋友要求帮忙开车，没想到他朋友为了财务纠纷抢别人的财物，这事件成了一起强盗案件。事前毫不知情的周贝奇因此成了共犯。
刚开始的时候，你会不会觉得很委屈？
会觉得很倒霉啊。但是正面思考，有学到东西也是不错啊。
刚进入社会的时候，会不会觉得别人用什么样特别的方式来对待你？找工作会不会比较难一点？
其实不会的嘞，因为没有像之前，可能没有像台湾没有像之前那么封建哦。你在路上，别人也不会知道说你是根生人。
找工作方面呢？
找工作方面有专长的话，其实不会啊。老板不会介意。
据了解， 彰化监狱其实也有其他出狱后参与花灯制作的前囚犯，可是周贝琪是少数能够坚持下去的，他的拼劲儿和对制作花灯的热忱也渐渐地受到认可。
为什么想到要继续做花灯？有没有其他的考虑或者其他的选择？
兴趣，它是一份，算起来是蛮稳定的收入，啊，可以应付家里的支出开销。
做花灯可以算是一种传统艺术，对不对？
是，它是啊。
传统的东西很多人都放弃啦，那为什么你还坚持下去？
可是以前传统是用竹编的方式，啊，我们现在是用铁线。或者是比较粗的铁管，如果你今天用竹编的话，可能两米三米就是已经很高了，但是我们用铁的工法下去做的话，其实可以做到五楼四楼那么高。
对制作花灯的焊接工匠来说，他不仅要把纸上的每一台花灯放大十到几百倍然后立体化，还得考虑到杠杆原理、重量和引力。
技巧是大家下去讨论，然后想办法更精进，从一开始很多的骨架到后来用最少的骨架去表现它最美的感觉。
我听说后来你也加入了花灯协会。
哦，是啊是啊是啊，是一些因缘际会下就加入了。
什么样的因缘际会？
刚出社会，然后自己为了想接工作，然后去跑，然后到后来有一些老师看到我们的努力然后他就邀我们一起加入他们的战队，这样子。
哇，这是你的作品吗？
对啊，哇，是在北港啊。
因为之前并不晓得有这门传统行业，所以周贝琪也从来没有想过自己会把制作花灯作为自己的职业。不过，由于制作花灯的焊接工作一直要创新，又具有一定的挑战性，所以引起了他的兴趣。
往后呢，你有什么样的展望？对于自己的未来有什么样的计划？
其实赚钱的方面，我觉得够用就好了，然后家里的妻小，然后爸爸妈妈就顾好就好了，然后最好是每年出国一趟哦，这就很棒了。然后目前为止是每年都有出国去玩一次，犒赏自己。
好像说中了知足常乐
啊，对，这样就好了，这样就好了。
对于剥夺自由的罪犯来说，他们中的绝大部分都要重返社会，但罪犯真正回归融入社会是一个任重道远的过程。由于罪犯个体情况的不同，回归社会的难度和后果也不尽相同。长时间的隔离会让他们对社会产生疏远的感觉，从而影响其返回社会的行为。这些监狱以特殊的方式帮助囚犯，让他们接受教化，并且学习一技之长，帮助他们在出狱之后能够展开新的人生。感谢您收看今天的凤凰大视野，下周我们同一时间再见。